In this video, we're going to solve a question from the Singapore Math Olympiad. Find the least prime factor of this number, 1, 0, 0, up to 0, 1. Between the two ones, there are 2,000 Tian zeros. Then how to solve this question? Let's check one by one, starting from the smallest prime number. First, let's see if this number is divisible by 2. Because this number is odd number, so it's not divisible by 2. Now let's see if it's divisible by 3. Since for any number, if it's divisible by 3, then the sum of its old digits should be divisible by 3. But here, the sum of digits is 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 is not divisible by 3. So that means this number is not divisible by 3. Next, let's see if it's divisible by 5. Since for any number, if it's divisible by 5, then the last digit should be 0 or 5. But here the last digit is 1, not 0 or 5. So that means this number is not divisible by 5. Next, let's check 7. But before we check 7, let's see a simple fact. So let's see what is the remainder of 10 to the third, 1 divided by 7. Then for 10, we can put as 7 plus 3, 10 to the third. So then for this term, we can use a binomial expansion. Then each term of the binomial expansion has a factor of 7 except the last term. So 1 divided by 7, the remainder depends on the last term, which is 3 to the third. Then 3 to the third equals 27. Then 27 equals 28 minus 1. 28 is divisible by 7. So then the remainder just negative 1. 1 divided by 7. So that means we have this result. Then just 10 to the third has remainder negative 1, 1 divided by 7. Now let's see if this number is divisible by 7 or not. Okay, since here we have 2,000 Tian zeros. So then for this number, we can put as following, as 10 to the power of 2011, then plus last digit, plus 1. Then for 2011, we can put as following. It just equals 3 times 670, then plus 1. Then here, plus 1. Then for 10 to the power 3 times 670, we can put as 10 to the third, then to the power of 670. Then plus 1 means times 10 to the power 1, then plus 1. The reason we're doing this, because for 10 to the third, we want to use this result. 10 to the third has a remainder negative 1, 1 divided by 7. So remainder is negative 1. So here, it has a remainder negative 1, then to the power of 670 times 10 to the power 1, then plus 1. Then negative 1 to this even power, so then just positive 1. Then here just equals 11. Then 11 has a remainder 4, 1 divided by 7. Since 4 is not a remainder, is a 4, it's not a 0, so that means this number is not divisible by 7. So next, let's see 11. See if this number is divisible by 11. So again, first, let's write this number as 10 to the power 2011, then plus 1. We want to see what is the remainder, 1 divided by 11. So then for 10, we can put as following, as 11 minus 1. Then to the power of 2011. Then for this one, we can use a binomial expansion. Then each term has a factor of 11 except the last term. So 1 divided by 11, the remainder just depends on the last term, which is negative 1 to the power of 2011, then plus 1. Then negative 1 to the power 2011, which is our number, so then just equals negative 1, then plus 1, then just equals 0. So here, divided by 11. Because the remainder is 0 when divided by 11, so that means this number, so it's divisible by 11. Again, because the remainder is 0. So that means 11 is the least prime factor of this number. So 11 is the answer for this question. Thanks for watching.